Can you see me? I am in Facebook, in your page. தெரியல வாழ்க்கை அதில் வருது சவுண்ட் இல்லையே தெரியல வருது புது
பசங்க
Can I speak? Are you hearing me? Can I start? What happened? Hello. Okay, so I'll start speaking now. Oh, okay. Sorry. Okay. Good evening, comrades, for this program, and I'm very happy to meet all of you through this program today, that has been arranged by the Maharashtra State Bank Employees Federation. It's really a very good initiative at this time of corona restrictions that we are able to communicate to each other on the current developments. Because communication is a very important part of an evolving society, and communication also has undergone a revolution in the recent decades. But unfortunately, trade unions, we are going by the same traditional way of communications in our networking. And the first thing is, this corona has taught us that we also have to adapt to this new technology and also the methods of communication. And that way I would appreciate the efforts of Maharashtra State Bank Employees Federation and Comrade Tuljapurkar for this new initiative. And I believe that we shall be able to acquaint ourselves very fast, and we shall be able to use this type of technology networking to communicate with our people. I am very happy to meet all of you. This corona has brought the lockdown, and along with that, our regular channels of communications are also under lockdown. So I believe that this is a helpful way of communicating. I'm very happy that this program has been arranged. But corona or no corona, the world is moving. The world has not come to a halt. World is moving, India is moving, the economy is moving, there are problems have come. And especially how we relate that problem to the bank employees and banking industry is what we are discussing today. The things are perhaps moving faster than what we imagine. And so naturally, these banks and the banking and the banking sector, which are very vital in any economy, much so in our Indian context, is equally understood by all of us. When we talk of challenges before bank employees, it cannot be diverse from the topic of banking industry itself. And banking industry, I don't want to take to the entire history and geography of the evolution of banking in our country. At least in the last 100 years, we know the modern banking, commercial banking has evolved. And then we come to 1947, Indian independence, and then to 1969, a very important watershed decision where banks were nationalized, again in 1980, some more banks. But again, a new pattern had come from 1990 where the privatization, liberalization in the banking industry that started. And it has come maybe a full circle today where FM also spoke of privatization of banks and more consolidation of banks, etc. So that way bank employees in this changing scenario, their challenges are also changing. I would like to address the challenges before the bank employees in two ways. One, their economic challenges. Number one, their challenges which are related to the banking industry in which they are working. As far as our own economic survival, or you will say betterment, is concerned, we know we started in 1946 in the All India Bank Employees Association, where at that time it was jungle law, totally jungle law. Bank employees were totally unprotected and uncared for, and nothing was possible. Naturally, that was a very horrible situation. From that, we find that slowly bank employees realize that there is not possible just to be lamenting or suffering the problem, but we must also try to do something to overcome the problem. And that's how we find that as a result of the ultimately, in 1946, we find that AABA was born, and that was a beginning of a transformation in the lives of the bank. Nothing, bank employees were treated like nothing at all, and slowly, slowly, bank employees movement has come, and today it's a complete transformation. And in the process, number one, that their service conditions were not existent, working hours was unheard of, and there was total exploitation of the bank employees. But with the advent of the trade union, 1946 AABA, we have seen, I am not taking much time to dwell on the past things, but the point is that today, because of the trade union in the banking industry, a lot of things have happened. Today, the job security has come. Earlier there was no job security, now there is a job security. Earlier there was no job permanency, now there is a job permanency. Earlier the wages were just pathetic, pitiable, and today we find that it is reasonable. I will not say it is adequate, I will not say it is satisfactory, but comparatively it is definitely better wages compared to the past. Similarly, service conditions are very, very important, and a lot of pro-employee service conditions have been achieved in the last 75 years. Now, AABA, we are celebrating the Platinum Jubilee year of the All India Bank Employees Association. Similarly, working hours, now for the past 1 week, we are finding that government after government, state government, they are now talking of 12-hour working hours. And that's why working hours are also equally very, very important in banks. When we talk of salary, we must rate that to the working hours. It is one of the lowest in the world. And even in India, when everybody is working 8 to 10 hours, we are working for 6.5 hours. So that's a very important thing that we have to keep in mind. Similarly, after retirement, as long as I work, I get remunerated, then matter is over. But it is not so. In banks, we have also evolved post-retirement security for the bank employees. Then dignity of job is so important that it's a very important achievement of the trade union in the banks. And more than that, I would rate the trade union rights of the bank employees. It's very, very important. That's a basic thing. The trade union rights have been achieved. And earlier, there was no bilateralism. It was purely tripartite, and we had to go before the courts and the tribunals and the awards. That was about 20 years. Then we realized, and then we came to the path of bilateralism. That means directly we talk to the banks, and in such a complicated banking scenario, whether a private banks and public sector bank, big banks, small banks, we are scattered in a lot of locations, but still from 1966 for almost 53 years now, this is the 54th year that we are maintaining the bilateral relationship. So this is one thing that we have seen. But alongside, the bank employees have also seen the challenge of the banking industry. Earlier, the entire banking industry was in the private sector, and now we are finding that we have moved over to the nationalized sector. There also, bank employees played a very important role, because right from the inception of the All India Bank Employees Association, it was our understanding of the founders of the All India Bank Employees Association, their vision that bank employees have to be guided by a two-pillar policy of the All India Bank Employees Association. One, of course, essentially, very importantly, that employees, bank employees, their betterment, their better living condition, their improvement, their service conditions, their more wages, etc. That is only one part. But at the same time, the founding fathers of the AIB also believed and they felt that the organization of the bank employees, the union of the bank employees, also should have another very important role to play. We must go back to 1946 when AIB was born. Independence was not yet there. It was still a British India. And that was a cry that we want independent. Gandhiji was fighting, people were fighting, workers were fighting, unions were demanding. Then we came to 1947. That was totally after 200 years of British exploitation. They simply looted our country, and then India became so poor. India was the top of the world's economy once upon a time. But all these invasions and exploitations made our country poor, and we are so backward. So our AIB leaders, founders, they also believed that one side you fight for the betterment of the bank employees. On the other side, we must ensure that banks also play the role in uplifting the economic condition of the people at large. And for that, naturally, India has to economically grow. And banks have a very important role to play, because agriculture was backward, everything was backward. So even at that time, they believed that in addition to gaining trade union rights, in addition to fighting for betterment of the bank employees, in a country like India, a developing country like India, a poor country like India, it's very, very important for unions also to play its role in development of the economy, progress of the economy, welfare of the people. These are all very, very important in All India Bank Employees Association. Different unions have different priorities, different objectives, different goals. But in AIBA, these are our twin objectives. We are guided by this two-pillar policy, betterment of the bank employees and a vibrant banking industry to ensure a vibrant country, vibrant economy, where people are able to progress. So when we talk of the challenges of the bank employees, it's very necessary that we travel on both these topics. So today we are talking of challenges before Corona and after Corona.